This is where multiprocessor comes in. If you're implementing this RPC package on a shared memory multiprocessor, then we can exploit multiple processors that are available in the SMP. What we can do is we can preload the server domains in a particular processor. And what we mean by that is if we preload a server domain in a processor and don't let anything else run on this processor, this particular server is loaded on CPU 2, we're not going to let any other thing disturb what's going on in the CPU. What that would mean is that the caches associated with the CPU will be warm with the stuff that this particular domain needs. So in other words, the server's address space is preloaded in a particular processor if you have multiple processors, and you can exploit the fact that you have multiple processors in the SMP. So if a client comes along and wants to make an RPC call, then what we want to do is use the server that has been preloaded in a particular CPU as the recipient of this particular RPC call. So when this client makes that call is going to be directed to the server that has been preloaded in a particular CPU. And since it's been preloaded in the CPU, the caches will be warm, and therefore we can avoid or reduce or mitigate the impact on loss of locality that I mentioned to you that goes on when you go from one protection domain to another protection domain. So this is the happy state of the world, where what we have done is we first of all eliminated kernel intervention in making the actual call and return between the client and the server by providing an argument stack in shared memory that is shared in the address space of the client and the address space of the server. And this way, the client can pass the actual arguments of the call to the A stack, and the server can retrieve it from the A stack without kernel intervention. And when the server is ready to return the results back to the client, once again, it can do the same thing, put it in the A stack so that it is available for the client. So without any kernel intervention, you can actually do the call and return. And of course, the mediation happens only in the fact that the kernel has to validate the call. Every time the client makes a call, it has to validate that call. But the loss of locality you can avoid by making sure that the server domain is preloaded in one of the CPUs. And the other thing that the kernel can do is look at the popularity of a particular server. If a server is serving lots of different clients, then in a multiprocessor, then it can potentially, based on the monitoring, decide that we may want to have multiple CPUs dedicated to the service, and that way you have several different domains of the same server preloaded in several CPUs to cater to the needs of several simultaneous requests that may be coming in for a particular service.